Bone can be compact or spongy. Compact bone is dense, and you'll see that in the outer layer. So when you're looking at a skeleton, all you see is compact bone. But within that bone, bone will get spongy or honeycomb-like. Sometimes that spongy bone is full of red bone marrow, sometimes of yellow bone marrow, which is fatty tissue. Recall that a long bone is longer than it is wide, and it has an epiphysis and diaphysis. The diaphysis is the shaft. Inside the shaft, which is compact bone, we have a cavity, which is a space called a medullary cavity, where marrow is located, either red or yellow. Mostly yellow if we're talking about adults. The epiphysis, epiphyses here plural, are the two ends that bulge out in a long bone. It contains spongy bone in the interior, and either will contain an epiphyseal line, which is a growth line, meaning the bone has done growing. However, if the individual is not done growing, it will be a growth plate or an epiphyseal plate, meaning the bone hasn't fused together yet. There also will be hyaline cartilage on the joint surfaces, which we know is called articular cartilage. So in this figure here, we see a long bone with an epiphysis at each end, diaphysis. In the diaphysis, we have a medullary cavity filled with the yellow bone marrow. In the epiphysis, we have spongy bone in the interior. Recall that compact bone is surrounding the entire bone. Here's an epiphyseal line. If this was a child, it would be an epiphyseal plate, and hyaline cartilage would span the plate. There's your articular cartilage, which is the hyaline cartilage at the ends of long bones. Lining the bone on the outside, which we see getting peeled off here, is the periosteum. Lining the inside of bone, which means lining the medullary cavity and lining the spongy bone, we have endosteum, which is not labeled here. The periosteum, which is the outer membrane, will contain osteoblasts that build bone, osteoclasts that break down bone, and then we have osteogenic cells, which are just stem cells that can become an osteoblast if bone needs to be produced. The periosteum has a lot of nerve fibers and blood vessels, and the periosteum is secured to the bone by something called Sharpey's fibers, which we'll see in an image. Here's the write-up on the endosteum. Remember, end or endo means within, osteum means bone. It's in the internal surface, so it covers trabeculae, which I haven't mentioned yet. Trabeculae is the structure of spongy bone. It's that honeycomb pattern. And the endosteum also covers lines the medullary cavity in the diaphysis. The endosteum also contains osteoblasts, which build bone, and osteoclasts, which break bone down. Here we're looking at a piece of diaphysis. Here's the medullary cavity that's filled with yellow bone marrow. And lining it is the endosteum. The periosteum lines the outside of bone, and you can see it getting peeled off here. And these fibers that are holding it very tightly to the bone are called Sharpey's fibers, or perforating fibers. When we're dealing with short bones, irregular or flat bones, therefore not long bones, there will not be an epiphysis and diaphysis, but there will be a periosteum and an endosteum. And occasionally we'll see hematopoietic bone marrow, which is red bone marrow, where blood is produced within the spongy bone, which is called trabeculae. When we're dealing solely with flat bones, there's an important structure called diploe, with those funny dots on top of the E. I'll show you what diploe is on a picture on the next slide. Here's an example of a flat bone. It's in the skull. It happens to be the parietal bone. When we look at this little piece of it close up, we can see we have spongy bone, which is sandwiched by compact bone on either side. So this structure right here with spongy bone in between compact bone, think of it as a spongy bone sandwich, that is what diploe is. Here's the location of hematopoietic tissue. That is red bone marrow. Recall, red bone marrow is where our blood cells are produced in our body. In adults, it will be different than infants. Infants have to produce much more blood than adults do, so there'll be a lot more red marrow in infants than in adults. But in adults, we'll see the red marrow in the spongy bone of the femur. Recall, the femur is the thigh bone. Trabecular cavities is the spongy bone, so in the heads of the femur or the epiphyses of the femurs, we'll see red marrow. Also in the diploe, recall that from previous slide, of all your flat bones, like the skull bone that we saw in the previous slide. In infants, there's a lot more red bone marrow. It's in all the flat bones, the diploe, the epiphysis, and the medullary cavities of long bones. So the entire interior of our long bones as an infant would be red bone marrow, which is hematopoietic or blood producing.